Hello everybody, today we are testing Autopilot 1 and Autopilot 2 on a very visually challenging road. Now this road I specifically chose to test the limits of navigation by vision system, so autopilot or full autonomous driving based on vision only, or mostly vision. I mean, we got radar and sonar, but that doesn't help you actually see lanes. It just helps you see other objects around. So you can see I already had to take over once for Autopilot 1. And for those not as familiar, Autopilot 1 only has a single forward-facing camera and is based on the Mobileye Autopilot system or hardware with, you know, Tesla's magic sauce put into the mix. Whereas Autopilot 2X and higher, so Autopilot 2 through full self-drive, is Tesla's own ground-up approach. Autopilot 1, as you see there, just had had a problem I had to take over there. Autopilot 2 is still chugging along, no problem whatsoever. Now, besides Autopilot 2X having 8 cameras, according to Elon and company at the Autonomy Day, and Autopilot 1 just had another fail there, and I'll just hold on a second here. Major fail there. Extreme deviation of lane for Autopilot 1. As you can see, Autopilot 2 handled that no problem. But back to what I was saying, according to Musk and company on Autonomy Day, Autopilot 2X hardware with full self-drive options are capable of basically projecting in a way 3D-based routes. So the car can put together what it believes will be the predicted route. So it knows that there's going to be an elevation change, such as right here on this, not only a blind right turn, and you can see it would have been a complete fail for AP1. It was going to leave the lane based on prior experience. AP2 is handling it good. While on the screen it doesn't show that, it shows that it's leaving its lane line, but in reality it did not. But with the extra cameras, long focal length, mid-range, and short-range wide angle, plus the side view cameras, it's able to follow those lane lines much more precisely. So we're going to go around a few more curves here. Now I started them off pretty much synchronized at the same starting point. Both I have set for 30 miles per hour, which is about the average people take on this road. Autopilot 1 just had a major failure, would have went up on the curb if I wouldn't have grabbed the wheel. Now my hands are only skimming the wheel. I am not physically holding the wheel because I did not want input from me as the driver to influence the autopilot and its driving in any way. So that was, we just finished up a medium to hard difficulty road. Now we're going to go for an extreme difficulty road here. And you'll see why in just a moment. Now coming up for Autopilot 2, I did take over at this point. Now it would have completed the curve. I actually took this curve a few more times off camera just to see what the reaction would have been. It would have been right here. Now AP1 completely spazzed out. AP2 would have taken that curve. However, it would have left its lane by about 6 inches to a foot. So in the interest of safety because of the oncoming car, I did disengage and grab the wheel myself. That was the only time in this entire test that I actually had to intervene. And you can see AP1 failed again. AP1's going to fail. Wouldn't even let me activate it. AP2 made that curve no problem. Now this is going to be even more difficult right here. We're going up. It's not only uphill, but it's also uphill with a sharp left. So AP1 already there. No sooner do I get it activated, I already have to take over. AP2 still made through just fine. Now this is a tough spot through this intersection right here because the lane lines are gone. AP2 still no problem. AP1 lost the lane line there. Now, about a year ago, AP1 could not navigate this section here. As of summer of 2018, it can. It does go over the lane line slightly, but it does make it through. going around the corner. AP2 is still not a problem. Only that one time I took over interest of safety, even though it would have completed that curve. But right here, as we pass that Century 21 sign, usually AP1 wants to skim the curb. As of last summer, it does try getting too close to the curb, but it doesn't actually touch it anymore or require me to take over. But it does get uncomfortably close, so I'm thinking that it was a possibility of me going past that specific section multiple times, allowed with the fleet learning that it should move over a bit. So thank you for watching. Please consider liking and subscribing. This video, believe it or not, was a lot of work to put together, a lot of footage to try and synchronize, and just a lot of work. So please like, subscribe, and be sure to share just to see how much Tesla has progressed. Thanks for watching.